Body tissues produce carbon dioxide as a result of their daily functions. This carbon dioxide is carried away from the tissues by the blood. This blood, loaded with carbon dioxide, is dirty blood. In order for the blood to be cleaned, it needs to make contact with the air. The oxygen in the air and the carbon dioxide in the blood will thus be exchanged. There are around 5 liters of blood in the human body. In order to be air, this 5 liters of blood needs to spread over an area of around 100 square meters. That is equivalent to the area of a tennis court. Everyone watching this film has an area the size of a tennis court squeezed into his lungs. By the incomparable art of God's creation. The lungs. The lungs consist of bronchia divided into hundreds of different tubes. At the end of each one of these bronchia fills the alveoli, or air sacs, the size of a pinhead. There are some 300 million of these air sacs in a healthy lung. Their total surface area is equivalent to that of a tennis court. The air passing through the bronchia fills the alveoli. The alveoli are covered with a dense network of capillaries, the smallest of the blood vessels. The alveoli and capillaries are separated from each other with a thin membrane. This membrane permits an exchange of gases between the blood and the air. The carbon dioxide in the dirty blood and the oxygen in the air are exchanged here. And the dirty blood is cleaned in the alveoli. The system which allows your blood to be cleaned with every breath you take is built on an air sac no larger than a pinhead. The fact that you have 300 million of these in your chest and that they all perform their functions at all time is another proof of the incomparable art of God's creation. Now let us have a closer look at these pinhead-sized alveoli and witness once again the perfection of God's creation. The alveoli inflate with every breath and return to their original form as the breath is released again. The interior surface of the alveoli is coated with a thin layer of water. And the water molecules create surface tension. Surface tension depends mainly upon the cohesive forces between water molecules. The surface tension formed by the water coating the alveoli would normally cause the alveoli to collapse at the end of exhalation. For that reason, we would normally have to expend enormous energy and suffer considerable discomfort in order to re-expand the alveoli which collapsed with every breath. Yet we manage to breathe perfectly comfortably. So what is the secret behind this? Scientists researching the answer to this question encountered a most important miracle here. A supportive organism has been placed inside each and every one of the 300 million alveoli to serve the human body. These are known as type 2 cells. Type 2 cells produce a very special substance called surfactant and spread this over the internal surfaces of the alveoli. Surfactant is a molecule especially designed to reduce the surface tension of water. Thanks to this molecule, the alveoli are prevented from collapsing inwards. At this point, we need to consider carefully. Type 2 cells possess no eyes, ears, brain, or capacity for thought, and are invisible to the naked eye. So how is it that this substance knows that the alveoli will collapse because of surface tension? You can now see the chemical formula for surfactant on the screen. This formula has been specially designed to do away with water surface tension. Who taught the type 2 cell, devoid as it is of eye, ears, or brain, the chemical formula for surfactant? Why does it devote its life to the production of this substance? This cell exists only in the alveoli, just where the surfactant is needed, and nowhere else in the body. Who was it who located it not in the ear or the heart, for instance, but solely where it needed to be, inside the alveoli? The number of such questions rises as one continues to study the alveoli, since the type 2 cells are not the only faithful workers in the alveoli. Other supporting cells have been located inside the alveoli. The macrophages, for instance. Any foreign body that manages to get by the security precautions in the upper respiratory tract and to reach the lungs represents a serious danger. Macrophages engulf these foreign bodies which enter the alveoli and thus protect our health. So who was it who charged the macrophages with standing watch over your alveoli all through their lives and thus protecting your health? There is only one answer to this and other such questions. It is God who creates the macrophages, the type 2 cells, the alveoli they are found in, the perfect design in those alveoli, the bronchi and the lungs. God's art of creation is flawless and incomparable. In one verse, God reveals, "Does not man see that we created him from a drop, yet there he is, an open antagonist? He makes likenesses of us and forgets his own creation, saying, 'Who will give life to bones when they are decayed?' Say, 'He who made them in the first place will bring them back to life. He has total knowledge of each created thing.'